Hello friends. I present to you another video dedicated to the operation of controllers for managing addressable LED strips based on WLED firmware. You can find a list of my previous reviews, featuring both factory-made and DIY solutions, in the description. This firmware offers a wide range of lighting effects, the ability to save settings as presets and combine them into playlists, work with LED panels and microphones, easy integration with Home Assistant, and much more. The hero of today's video is the special Gledopto GL-RC-001WL Wi-Fi remote control, designed for direct control of such controllers, not only from the same brand but also any controllers based on WLED firmware. It provides an alternative way to control addressable lighting without relying on smart home systems or apps. Before we begin, as always, please like this video to help other viewers interested in this topic find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Device type, remote control. Model, Gledopto GL-RC-001WL. Interface, Wi-Fi. Number of buttons, 9. Power supply, 2 AAA batteries. Standby power consumption, less than 13 microamps, i.e., only 13 millionths of an ampere. Transmission power, 6 dBm, which corresponds to approximately 4 milliwatts. Range, up to 50 meters. Protection class, IP20. Size, 39x16x143mm. Weight, 62 grams. The remote arrived in packaging that's quite unusual for Gledopto products. Delivery took about 2 weeks. On the back of the packaging, you can find the technical specifications, which I have already mentioned. Another important note, for the remote to work, the firmware of your WLED controller must be at least version 0.14.0, beta 3. The package includes the remote itself and a manual. The remote has a classic appearance, with an activity LED located on the front under semi-transparent plastic. There are 9 buttons: power on, power off, night mode, brightness control, and quick access to 4 presets. On the back is the battery compartment. Note that the batteries are not included in the package. The remote requires 2 AAA cells, which can be either batteries or rechargeable ones, but preferably with a supply voltage of 1.5V instead of 1.2V. The manual is small and in English, but it contains everything necessary to connect the device. I will show you all of this in the video. I want to draw your attention to one important point. To save battery, the remote goes into sleep mode 2 seconds after the last button press. Therefore, to correctly transmit the next command, you need to either hold the button for 1 second or press it twice. When you press a button, a blue LED lights up. The remote works with any controller or fixture based on WLED firmware, as long as the firmware version is compatible. For testing, I will use a device from the same manufacturer. The link to its review can be found in the description. In my previous reviews, I covered the web interface of WLED controllers in detail. You can find those links in the description. Checking the firmware version on the controller, I have 0.14.4 installed, which is more recent than the required version. We go to the configuration tab, and here we need the Wi-Fi settings section. This section contains information about your home network, where the controller operates, and access point settings if the device loses signal. We need to find the section called Wireless Remote, and in it, mark the Enable Remote Control option. Save the settings and wait a bit for them to apply. Then, on the remote, press any button and hold it for at least 1 second. Returning to the Wi-Fi settings section, we see the remote's MAC address in the last seen field. That's why we held the button earlier. Copy the MAC address and paste it into the field above. Save the applied settings. Now, the remote can control power, brightness, and soon we will test this. For now, let's set up presets. In the interface, set your desired palette, effect, and its parameters. Click the Add Preset button on the right. This will save all applied settings for quick access. The name is not crucial here. The key for the remote is the ID. Its number corresponds to the button number. In this case, button S1 will trigger it. You can have as many presets as you want. Remember that presets can be combined into playlists, although this functionality belongs to the firmware interface and is also available in Home Assistant. I use specific combinations of effects and palettes as visual notifications for certain events. But back to the remote, it is designed for manual control of the controller and can activate saved presets numbered 1, 2, 3, and 4. While this may seem limited, in practical use, it's often enough. During testing, each button press activates the LED on the remote. Remember that you need to hold the buttons briefly to wake the remote from sleep mode. Brightness control. Preset activation. In night mode, which dims the brightness to a minimum, all work as expected. In my smart home system, I currently use four controllers based on WLED firmware. Two of them are exclusively for visual notifications, including the Gledopto WLED light bar. Link to its review is in the description. The other two control strips with 600 LEDs each, used as atmospheric lighting fixtures. Preset switching on them is set up via wireless buttons and in Telegram menus, but the remote turned out to be more convenient for daily use. For presets are quite sufficient, especially since usually only one is used. By the way, you can use the remote simultaneously with multiple controllers by specifying the same MAC address in their settings. Overall, my impressions are positive, and I'm considering ordering another remote for the second strip. The only things missing are a wall mount and perhaps a few extra preset buttons for those who need more than four. That's all for now. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you. I'd appreciate your likes, as they help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, I'll leave links to the stores where you can order this remote, as well as links to other reviews on this topic. You'll also find links to my Telegram channels, Facebook page, and a group for discussions about smart home questions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thanks for watching, see you soon, and peace to everyone.